Let's discuss one more example based on the similar concept. It is saying one fine day up to 12 noon, a pendulum and a digital clock show same time at 30 degree centigrade. And if suddenly temperature is increased to 50 degree centigrade, then at 3 pm it is decreased to 20 degree centigrade. We are required to find time when both clocks will show same time again. In this situation, if we just have a look on the statement that at 30 degree centigrade, pendulum and a digital clock show same time. That means 30 degree centigrade is the graduation temperature of the pendulum. Because we know that digital clock does not vary with the temperature. So, we can assume that the digital clock is always showing the accurate time. And pendulum clock was in sync with digital clock as 30 degree. That means at 30 degree it was showing correct time. And if suddenly at 12 noon the temperature is increased to 50 degree. Certainly we can state that due to rise in temperature by 20 the clock will slow down. It will start losing time. And at 3 pm after 3 hours when it is decreased to 20. You can say it is 10 degree below the graduation temperature. So, now clock will start gaining time. That means it will be fast compared to the actual time. So, when the total time lost by the clock will be equals to the total time gained by the clock, then we can state that pendulum clock will also show the correct time and it will be in sync with digital clock. So, both clock will show same time again. So, we can write here both clocks will show same time when total time lost by the clock is equals to total time gained by the clock. And we know that total time lost or gained can be calculated by half alpha delta t multiplied by the duration. So, in this situation, we can state from 12 noon to 3 pm within 3 hours total time loss we can calculate as half alpha delta t multiplied by we can use 3 hours must be equal to total time gained can be written as half alpha delta t dash because the variation temperature will be different multiplied by you can say we multiplied by T1 as T1 are the number of hours after which the total time gain will be equal to total time loss. Now in this situation half alpha gets cancelled out initially when the temperature was increased to 50. This delta T can be written as 20 multiplied by 3 hours is equal to delta T dash can be written as 30 minus 20 that is 10 into T1. On solving we get T1 is equals to 6 hours. That means the time when both clock will be in sync will be final time at which clocks will be in sync can be written as because after 3 pm it was started so this will be 3 plus 6 that will be 9 pm when the two clocks will show the same time. So, you can write it 9 pm or 21 hours is the answer to your problem.